फ्रेंड्स, मोहित मित्तल इज बैक विद अ न्यू वीडियो फॉर ग्रेड 10th इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज एंड लिटरेचर. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस विद अ पोएम अ टाइगर इन द जू फॉर ग्रेड 10th. फाइन, दिस पोएम इज ऑल बेस्ड फॉर वाइल्ड एनिमल्स. हियर द पोएट लेस्ली नॉरिस टॉक्स अबाउट टू कीप द वाइल्ड एनिमल्स अवे फ्रॉम द होम और द जूज to keep them in their natural habitat, that is the jungles or the forest. So let's come to the poem. Basically two literary devices are used here. One is alliteration and other is repetition. Alliteration is all about repetition of consonant sounds, and repetition is the repetition of the words itself. When we'll have the literary device in the poem or the poetic device, I'll describe there further. Without wasting much of the time, let's switch on to the poem. He stalks in his vivid stripes. See, he is the tiger here. He stalks in his vivid stripes. The few steps of his gaze. The tiger, that means the tiger walks in the limited space. Why the space is limited? Because the tiger is all in the cage. On pads of velvet, quiet, in his quiet rage. Rage means anger. On pads, pad means the paws, etc. of velvet, quiet. That means the paws are very soft, like velvet. In his quiet rage means no noise is produced by wild animal or the tiger when it walks on the pad. He should be lurking in shadow. Lurking in shadow. Lurking means hiding. Sliding through long grass near the waterhole where plump deer pass. See, he should be lurking in shadow. Means cage is not in proper place. According to the poet, tiger or wild animal should not be in concrete cage, etc. They should be left free in their natural habitat. Sliding through the long grass means somewhere the tiger would be at this time would be moving in the grasses, etc. Near the water hole where the plump deer pass. And as soon as tiger see any deer or any wild creature that is the prey, the tiger would just slide water the slide to kill the prey. So first and second stanza. First stanza says that the tiger is silent but in rage. And the second paragraph says that, second stanza implies the tiger should be in forest, should be kept in forest, the natural habitat. Let's switch on to the third stanza. He should be snarling around the houses. Snarling means showing teeth, etc. At the jungle edge. That means tiger should be running around near the houses at the edge of the jungle. Bearing his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. This tiger, he should be glowing. He should be glowing in his voice. Why? To terrify the people. Means somewhere the tiger should show the rageous nature. But he is locked in a concrete cell. It implies that the poet expresses the deep sympathy here that the tiger is all bounded in the four walls of the cage. His strength behind bars, stalking. Stalking means walking. The length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Means somewhere the poet shows the sympathy on tiger, that the tiger is imprisoned in the concrete cell. Concrete cell means cell made of stones and cement. And the strength behind the bar, tiger's strength is all locked in the bars. Stalking the length of his cage, ignoring the visitors. Means tiger has no interest, tiger shows no interest towards the visitors. Why? Because he is walking in the angry mood and walking only in the cage. He has nothing else around this habit now. He hears the last voice at night. With somewhere the tiger keep on watching and staring here and there. The patrolling cars and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. This tiger get disturbed at night. Even the tiger stays awake complete night. Tiger hears the sound created by the cars of the zoo's authority. Please pay attention. I'm repeating one more line. The tiger tiger stays awake and moreover hears the sound created by the cars of the zoo authority and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. So tiger has none other word, just staring at the stars. Why the this tiger is staring at the stars? Because the poet has raised one moral issue here that present the strong case against the cruelty towards the animal. Is somewhere the poet want to say that the tiger or wild animal should not be kept in cages or in zoos. Right there and kill the prey. So with a simple explanation, let me end with the poem that the wild animals must be kept free according to the poet so that they enjoy their natural environment. Now let's talk about where the two literary or the poetic devices are used. One was repetition. See, in the first stanza itself, on pads of velvet quiet, in his quiet rays, quiet, quiet, to the same word has been repeated twice in two lines. So it is repetition. Now alliteration, if I talk about, he stalks in his vivid stripes. The sound, consonant sound, S is repeated. So here I end up with a simple poem, that is The Tiger in the Zoo, where the poet stresses on that the animals, etc., should not be kept behind the bars. Rather, they should be left free so that they enjoy the natural environment or the natural habitat, that is the forest. And we as human beings must not let them lead a life which is all behind the cages. I hope the poem is clear to everyone. Let's talk about some of the words used here. Vivid. Vivid means clear. V-I-V-I-D. Second word is pads. P-A-D-S. That means feet. Third word is rage. R-A-G-E. That means anger. Next word is lurking. L-U-R-K-I-N-G. That means hiding. Next word is snarling. S-N-A-R-L-I-N-G. That means showing teeth. Next word is bearing. B-A-R-I-N-G. That means showing. Next word is, I hope.